All right, this is part two of the Alundra tutorial. So we already went through the entire coal mine. We beat the Merg here, and we got the life vessel here. So this would have been the end of the coal mine split. So next, we are going to leave the coal mine. Do this little cutscene here. The next little bit of the game is pretty much cutscene city. We do this. Hold up and left. Up and out this way. This, you want to get up here, and then dash up, not go into the wall, like that. And then this is an autopiloted cutscene, so I'm going to fast forward through this with my handy dandy emulator stuff. So there's no inputs required here. You might think that this is long enough to be a bathroom break, but it really isn't. Like, for bathroom breaks for me, the minimum time's like 45 to 50 seconds, and this one is not quite that. It's more like 30-35, and there's going to be a longer input break coming up here anyways. So at this point, you want to be holding down and right because we get control again, and then we exit south through the screen. You want to dash down this way and to the right, back the way we came. Hug the left wall as you're going down here. This will be a setup for the way we leave the screen. So after this scene, we're going to be heading back to town. Alright, so we're going to dash down along the left side here. Keep holding down and dash. Keep holding down and dash. And then we're here, we're going to exit south through this screen. And now we're heading back to town. So right across the bridge here, north through the screen transition. And a hop twice, right here. And then this part might look familiar, this is right next to where town is. We want to take this little shortcut right here again. Because it's slightly faster than hopping across the water there. So next, instead of going back to Alundra's house, we're going to go visit Sybil. So there's an NPC currently blocking our house right there. So before we go in there, we're going to go and talk to Sybil, which is what woman blocking the door wants us to do. So Sybil's house is right over here. And now we're going to go talk to her for some cutscenes. So I mentioned before that there is a bathroom break. This is the first bathroom break in the game. There are two halves to this cutscene. So the first half of the cutscene is 50 seconds starting from here of no inputs. So if you have something that takes 50 seconds to do, do it after you say yes to that text box and dismiss the text, because there's nothing that happens here for 50 seconds. And then there are two text lines from this guy in the middle of this cutscene. So you have to dismiss some text in the middle of this cutscene. And then after that is 1 minute and 10 seconds. Where you don't have to put in an input. So, in total, there's 2 minutes of input break in this little cutscene sequence here. Just know that there is a text box in the middle of it, which is right here. So you want to be holding down the square button for when he moves in the center of the screen again. Right there. So dismiss this. And now we got 70 seconds of uninterrupted time here. So there's three bathroom breaks in the run. This is the first one. The second one is roughly halfway through the game. And the third one is about 20-ish minutes before the end of the game. So generally, you don't need that one. You technically don't need any of them, but this is a relatively long run. So don't give yourself kidney stones by doing anything rash. There's three bathroom breaks, you should use at least two of them. So again, no inputs needed at all here. You can just put down the controller if you need to. Thank you. Alright, so we skip some text here. With, what's her face? Sybil. And now we're heading back to Jess. The woman will still be standing in the way of the door, but once we talk to her, she'll move out of the way. Right here, you talk to her. And then we go on in here. This is an automatic cutscene with Jess that starts. You don't have to move at all. So after all this talking, you still have to press up to go get the flowers, I believe? I think? Maybe? I'm gonna hold up anyways, just because. Okay. But you don't. Alright, so we got the flowers. Now next is we're going to the cemetery. We're going down this way. We're gonna take the upper right exit to the village. Right up this way. And we're headed to the graveyard. So there is a time saver coming up here. I'm going to set a save state. So when you do this fast, you want to do that. And that puts the flowers on there. So you can see that there is a text box right here that says releaser, releaser. If you take too long to do this, the second text box appears that has all that text. And then you eventually get up here and do that. So if you do this fast enough, you can actually make it to that door without the second text box appearing. So let's see if I can get it here. I like that. So you can actually get to the door before that second long text box appears, and it saves all the time from that, from all that happening. Alright, so this is the start of Lara's Crypt. So first things first, we're going to go solve the first puzzle here for the dungeon. And the solution for it is to talk to the center one. And then left, right, left, right. So you jump over that to this one. Over to this one. You can dash straight up into that one. Really on that. So center, left, right is the solution. It's really easy. So once you talk to this guy, we're done with this part, but we still need to go talk to the guy that gives us the quest for this. So we gotta go over here into this door, and we have to talk to this guy twice. We talk to that. Keep holding up at this point while you're going through this text. Keep holding up. It's important. Keep holding up. Okay. So now you can let go of him. Now that we've triggered the second dialogue with him. But here you gotta be ready to say yes to the guy. So the X button. Right here. And now hold triangle and down. And we can leave. So now we go down to the bottom section again to trigger this. This is all the wise men appearing. No way to speed this up. So all five have to appear slowly. They open the door, and then they teleport out again. Okay, in this next scene, we'll make a save state here. So there is a setup for this. Actually, we'll save state right here. So when you read both of these plaques, enemies spawn. So there is a zombie on the right, a zombie on the left, and then two scythe guys. So if you use the sword to attack these guys, it takes forever. You can see just how many hits it takes to get rid of these guys. Just actually forever to get rid of these guys. Alternatively, you can use pots to just one-shot. The real strat, though, is you go down here, read that one, leave a bomb there, and then you do that. So a bomb on the left plaque, leave a bomb on the left, a bomb in the middle, read the right plaque, so the monsters spawn, and then throw a pot at the zombie on the right, and that's a quick way to do that. Up here, there's two herbs. Get those if... I pretty much get those in any category in any run, so that's just two herbs for you. So next we go down this way. The opening to the floor extends all the way down here, so you don't need to like go all the way over here and fall in. You can actually do it from right there. Okay, hit that, and then get on this. Go up and talk to the statue, which will get you your health back if you were missing some. Go across here, hit the button. Go across here. Alright. There's a complicated and kind of dumb strat to hit these, but just do this. Just hit that, hit that, hit that, and hit that. And that'll cause this guy to spawn. There's something dumb you can do with bombs to, like, very slightly speed that up, but don't worry about it. Just don't bother doing that strat. Alright, in the next room we got another combat area. I'm gonna quick save here. Okay, so, like before, you always want to use pots to kill stuff, especially the zombies, because the zombies have a ton of health. So there's... Alright, we'll just kill the zombie the regular way. See how long this takes. Especially if they get away from you like that. So, use the pots on the zombies and don't miss. Is the strat for this room. Also, if you're low on money, like at this point, below 60, pick up all the extra money. So here we dash over here, go over here, hop into here, and then this. We get this key. Oop. Don't fall in those holes. If you do fall in the hole, here's how you get out of it. We just go up to this, so it can put you over here. Just go up here, and this brings you over to there. So that's what happens if you fall in that hole. I think I already got the key. Alright. So here, when you enter this room, you want to slash this, dash through that, and then dash up. That's how you do that. This room has a particular strat for it, so you go push that, and then we'll quick save here. So you ride this, stay on this part of the platform for now. Once that clips through there, move over to the left and then down. And then here you want to grab this immediately and then go across like that. That can be very tricky to do. So this one, you'll probably have to practice a bit to get this just right. But this saves all the time it would take to go all the way around the room. The amount of leeway you have to do this is, it's really not that hard, but you can't jump too early. And if you happen to fall in here, the way that you fix this is you have to kill all of the slimes that are in the room. Can take forever. And then that opens up this door right here, which goes to this part of the room. So, to reset if that happens, you just go like this all the way up into here. And this lets you do that, that puzzle again. So this one, probably have to practice a bit. This is one of the harder earlier game things that you have to do, but with some practice, it's really not that hard. So anyways, you do that, you talk to the statue, and that causes this this other part of the dungeon to open up. And this gives you your health back, if you're missing some. down and through here. Alright, in the next part here, you want to hug the left wall. Stop running right about here. And then instead of just walking onto this, you want to jump. Because there's no way to move while you're on this. So jumping gives you a little bit of extra momentum here. Okay, so for this, there is a little skip here. So my visual cue for this is... actually, I'll just show you this full speed. Right here, you go over here, talk to this, and then we're going to go get back on the platform again. Before it leaves. The visual cue that I use is that once the platform gets right about here, this edge of the platform gets about halfway up this second one, so it's like parallel with this flat part of the arrow. That's when I jump around this corner and go to the sign. Skip this text as fast as you can, but don't mash. And then keep holding left and then down to make it on this. This is another thing that can take some practice to get. Alright, and then we dash into this next room right here. Okay, in this room, you want to start over here, dash down, do a standing slash on that, run up here, jump slash, jump slash. And then continue to the next room. Run up here, grab a pot, hit that one with the pot, hit that one with the pot. And then hit that one 5 times in the US version. And then you want to go back this way. Standing slash, jump slash, jump slash, exit this way. Same deal, use a pot on this one. Use a pot on this one. Hook around the left side for this one. And then through here. Keep dashing to the right. And then this is where I split. So, this is the Ancient Guardian boss. This boss has a very crazy strat for it. I'll go over the crazy strat and the normal strat for this boss. So the normal strat for this boss is to just hit it with your dagger. This is the safest strat for this boss. There's a few things this boss can do. For the patterns that its boulders can take. Generally, you don't want to stand too close to this boss. Because it has iframes and it can move during those iframes. Also, you want to aim to hit it as quickly as its invincibility frames wear out. If you can hit it fast enough, it won't be able to spawn boulders on you. An intermediate strat to do for this boss is shoulder charge, because that does more damage to the boss than just the normal dagger does. If your health gets low on this boss, remember we still have all of these herbs that we've had throughout most of the run. And if you're in early attempts at an Alendra run, chances are you're gonna have plenty of herbs by this point. But don't be afraid to use them on bosses specifically. These are some of the most dangerous parts of the run. So in the US version, this boss just takes forever, as you can see. The Japanese version of this boss takes like 25 hits to kill with the dagger. The US version of the boss takes like 40 hits, maybe? With the regular dagger, so it takes forever. That's a normal way to kill the boss. So you can see how long that took. That took a while. We split there. Now I'll show the other strat. So the other strat uses something called the Infinite Bomb Trick. So I'll show it in full speed here, see if I can get it. Didn't get it there. So this is tough to get. So what you need to do here is pull out a bomb. Didn't work there either. This is how hard it is to do. So you need to pull out a bomb, throw it near the boss, damage boost. There we go, got it. Damage boost off of the boss. And then pull out a bomb just as the bomb you placed on the ground is exploding. And then you can probably see what I'm doing with the D-pad right now and the square button. So I need to press different direction inputs on the controller while the bomb's exploding. And you can see what that does, and also how quickly it kills the boss. So that's essentially how that trick works, and also how dangerous that trick is. So it saves a ton of time, but it's super dangerous to do. I don't recommend doing that until you're really comfortable with how this works. But it is something, an option to do. So I'll show this in kind of slow motion here. So we pull out a bomb here. I'm going to throw the bomb. Okay. So there's the bomb. We're damage boosting right now. I'm going to pull out a bomb right here. Just as the other bomb's exploding. And then I'm going to hold a direction. That's essentially what it is. So it's really hard to do it when it's slow here. Alright, so there's the bomb. Once you notice it start to blink, you're gonna damage boost into there, pull out your bomb while it's exploding, and then as the as you see it explode in your hands, you want to do left, right, down, up, just alternate. Don't do the same input twice in a row. That's what breaks the glitch. Let's see if we can get it one more time here. So the important bit for this is that you are damaged while this happens. That you're blinking. So, you can see I'm alternating left, right, down, up, left, down, right. I'm not doing the same direction twice. Here's what happens if you do it the same direction twice. The bomb disappears. So if that happens, just go back to fighting the boss. And if you really want to, you can do this. And you can do the glitch again. So if you're wondering if this trick works on other bosses, this trick only works on bosses that have a large hitbox. So, not necessarily. The only boss that it's really useful on is this one. Because we'll have strats for the other bosses. So in your first runs, I won't blame you at all if you don't do the infinite bomb. Because it is something that takes practice. Okay, so let's move on. That was the Ancient Guardian. That was both the regular strat and the Infinite Bomb strat. As usual, we split on that. And let's move on. Okay, so here we talk to Rave Ghost, or Lars. There's going to be three chests to open on the right side. You want to open all three, because you can't not open all three. Text is so slow on emulator with the slow jingle. Oh man. Alright, so after the third one, we get a text box here. We gotta go open this one. Right? So next we get on the teleporter and back to town. So hold up and dash. We leave Lars Crypt. Alright, so next we're going back to town. And technically the next thing is Bonair's dream, or Bronair's dream. But before we start that, we're going to make a little shopping trip. So this is a consistency strat. Not necessarily a safety strat, but more consistency. You'll see why when we get to that. So we're going to go in the shop here. And we're going to get this. This is an MP potion. Or magic elixir. It gives you your charge of magic back after you use it. Okay, so then from the store here, we're going to dash right and down. Down from that spot, because it gets us down here a little bit faster. Into Nadia's house. We're going to dash up right here. You want to align with the carpet. That's how you know when to go up. Go in here, and we want to talk to everybody on the left side of the room, not a woman in blue dress. You don't need to talk to her. We talk to Mira, talk to Nadia, and talk to Septimus. While you're talking to Septimus, hold down and right on the D-pad, because that's where we're going next. Right over here. And then we have autopilot on these conversations for a little bit. So we'll fast forward through this. You know when you get control of Alendra again, because Alendra will move to the bottom left of the bed. And then you'll see a text box that doesn't have a portrait next to it, and that's when you know you have control again. Keep going through this. Okay, so this one, here's where you get control again. We're gonna dash on out. Down and out of the house. So next stop is Bronair's house, which is the house right next to here. Right on up into Bronair's house. And then from here we're going to talk to everybody in the room. The last person we're going to talk to is Bronair, who's in the bed on the right. We're going to talk to Klein and Ronin first. Talk to this guy, talk to this guy. Don't talk to this guy from too far up, because you won't be able to. And then talk to Bronair last. And now this dude will come in, say some stuff. It'll give us the prompt to say yes or no when we turn right. Talk to Bronair again. And hit the X button, say yes. Okay, so now we're into Bronair's dream proper. Okay, so Bronair's dream. This one, there's a little cutscene at the very start. Make a quick save here. Alright, so at the start, you want to dash up this set of stairs, stop right here, and slash. Go down this way, down the stairs, up here, and then onto this teleporter. Here I dash down and stop right here, and I usually go between these two to make it through there. And up here to the teleporter, dash down, and then we're going to go to the right. Do another dragon orb thing right here. Dash this way, and then down onto this. Grab the key that's in here. And then go on over here. And here we're going to go this way, up over here. Through here, there's four slimes in here that we want to slash. Grab any health and or money that those things drop. Go down here, hit this, and then go into the teleporter. The next is a time-sensitive part here. So you go down, push this, jump over it immediately, go up the ladder. You can make this if you're quick. Okay, that wasn't quick enough, but it was good enough. Go on up here and up here. Depending on how fast you are for this, say if you wanted to take your time, you can wait here for these to go by. Wait over here. Wait for that. See, so that can happen. If you get knocked off, you just have to do this again. So take care not to get hit too many times here, because you will need your health for a part coming up. So if you're patient, you can make that without getting knocked off, but we're trying to go fast, not be patient. So there's a cutscene here. Alright, over here we hit the button. We walk out. Have your bomb still equipped. If it's not still equipped, then just go in there and equip it. Over here you want to jump and pull out your bomb at the same time. Throw it down there and then stand up here. Alright, next we're going to run this way. Let go of your run just before the door so that you don't bonk. Run up here, hit this. Run down about halfway down this staircase. And then jump up onto there. Run up here. Flash that. This is optional, but it might as well not be. So there's a life vessel with a health upgrade here, so don't worry about healing before this point if your health is low, because you're going to get your health back here anyways. And then go into the teleporter. Down and right, and out of here. So hold right and dash to go to this cutscene. And this cutscene, you just want to mash on square to make this go faster. And then after this, on this bridge is going to be four zombies and a spike ball that spawn. Eventually where we want to get to is the top of this screen right here where Sarah is. So what we're going to be doing is damage boosting off of the first zombie on the bridge, and then while we're invulnerable from that, we run through all the other stuff that's on the bridge. So immediately after this right here, you want to hold right at this point. And then after this, you want to hold triangle and just keep holding that until you're through all this and then up. Okay, so I split for Sarah right when he stops moving there. Okay, so this is the Sarah fight right here. This is horrible. So there's multiple ways to do the Sarah fight. You can quick kill Sarah with one bomb, but getting that kill is ridiculously difficult. So there's multiple phases of the fight. First phase is the shot spawn. Second phase is either going to be this pattern, which is the single Sarah. And then here's the shots appearing again. The other pattern is a ring of Sarahs. Like that. So, this was kind of the old strat of just throw bombs in this triangle pattern here and hope for the best. There we go. So, one bomb killed Sarah there. So, that's kind of the risky strat. If you weren't going to get a magic elixir, then that would be the strat that you would do. And that's the pattern of things that you do. So the other strat here is we go into our menu and equip the Earth Scroll while we're in it. So it's going to start off with the purple shots, as always. And now we want to stand in the center here, wait for her to spawn, and then if she spawns next to you, just hit her immediately. Okay, then we go in here, use the magic elixir, and then go back to the Earth Scroll. So dodge these again, hang out in the middle, wait for all of them to spawn, and then go like that. So because this is the US version, that isn't enough to kill the boss. So we have to hit her a couple more times here in the US version to make this a bit faster. You could also, while you're doing this, drop bombs to go for the quick kill, but this is just kind of how the US version is. Boss fights just take way longer. Right there. That's essentially the quickest you can do the Sarah boss fight in the US version. In the Japanese version, it is precisely to Earth Scrolls to kill the boss. So you so after the fight, you want to talk to talk to Brunner. So in the U.S. version, in general, on average, it would probably be faster to skip the magic and just use bombs. In the Japanese version, you might as well just take the extra 10 or 15 seconds or so to be guaranteed a two cycle on Sarah, as long as you don't miss. That's also the big if here. Yeah, also have to not miss on your Sarah shot. So we got some hot plot here, including one of the best dialogue lines in the entire game. Alright, get ready for it. Are you ready for this? Alright, right here. Right there. I'll just leave that there for a second. Just look at that. Okay. Alright, fast forward. Alright, so next up is the Ancient Shrine part of the run. This is one of the most difficult parts of the run, so prepare your body for what's coming up here. First things first, we're going to go and get an item from Jess, which we will need to finish the run. If you're going to do, like, safety saving strats, now would be a good time to do it. So, there's where you'd save. So you go down here, and then, I mentioned before that sometimes it's faster to, run or sprint down the stairs, sometimes it isn't. For this one, do not sprint. Just go right and up and over here. And, it'll save you like a second over dashing. So here we get the flail. You have to press up to actually get it. It isn't given to you automatically. Okay. Now we go down and leave. So, we're going to need another magic potion, so we're going to go down here, into the shop, where we're going to get another MP potion. This is why we needed specific amounts of money earlier in the game. Alright. You can only carry one magic elixir, if you're wondering. In case you're wondering, that's why we didn't buy two for the last boss fight, because you can only hold one. Alright, next we're going to leave the village through the south entrance, or exit in this case, and then we're gonna head through the west screen exit here. We're gonna open up our menu right here and open up or equip that and that, so we have the bomb and the flail right here. We're gonna take out our bomb and throw it on that stump there. Okay, head this way, break that, and then head north through this screen. So here we're going to collect the second magic upgrade in the game. So this will give us our second magic seed for two casts of magic. Okay. And then from here, instead of going directly to the desert, we're going to go do a sequence break. Isn't that exciting? We're going to head up this way, and we're going to leave through the north exit here to the coal mine area. We're gonna head over this way, up to this part. You might remember this as a screen just north of the village. And we're going to head north along the left side here. Don't go across the water because we can't move fast on water yet. Head on up through these steps. Go on the left side and then dash up. Go to the left here, dash up again. Head right across here, you can dash from here. Use the flail on this to break it. Hop down there. Dash here, dash here. Go down a little bit, dash to the right, go under this bridge. Go right, down through here. Right down. Right here. You're going to want to pull out your bomb to make this jump. That makes that jump much easier. Again, you can make it like that, but using a bomb for newbie jumps means your positioning doesn't have to be that precise. Head up this way, and then go through this exit right here. Okay, so this is a screen where the big, big gnarly skip happens. Okay, so here's what we're going to be doing. We're going to be jumping from here over to here to get access to this chest. This is the Earthbook chest. So normally this jump is impossible to do. But as we've learned, having an item makes these jumps actually possible because it gives us an extra animation frame. So the setup for this jump is actually pixel perfect, and there is a frame perfect jump that you get to make, or a three frame perfect jump, if that's the thing, for this. So there's a consistent setup for this at least. So what we're going to do here is we're going to bonk in the wall and then continue holding up until where our feet are on the ground again. Just like that. If you let go of that, that puts you too far back here. So you want to keep holding up as your bonk is in progress. Right there. Until you're right there. Okay, so now the next step is we need to do a short shoulder dash to the south. So I'm going to hold down triangle, hold down X, and then tap down. And that puts us on the exact correct pixel where we need to be right here. And then the next step, I'm going to make a save state here. You should do the same if you're practicing this. You need to pull out your bomb, and then we need to do a jump like that. That's how you do it. I got it second try. So let's do this frame by frame. So I am jumping. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then right about there or so, I'm holding down and to the right. I believe that's how many frames it is. Is 10? That's not quite. Okay. But essentially, it's down and to the right. Once you get just about to that that spot there. If you do down and straight right, it's a one frame trick to do. A one frame window to do that. So I recommend doing the down and right. But again, this is a three frame window to get, which is a 20th of a second, I think, is how much time you have to do that. So if you miss the jump for some reason, throw away your bomb, just go up here, and then do the setup again. So do the bonk, short shoulder dash down, and then keep trying at it. This sequence break saves quite a bit of time throughout the run, so it's important that you be able to do this. In your early runs, don't worry about getting this quickly. Just focus on getting the setup correct, like learning the motions on how to do it quickly. And then you'll get there eventually. This is, I can't stress enough that this is a very, very precise trick to get. So do not get flustered if you're not able to get this super quickly. Okay, so then we open the Earthbook chest and get the Earthbook. This gives us the Earthbook magic way earlier than the game intends us to. Once we get that, we go over here. This part's important, that when you're dropping down from here, you stay up here. If for whatever reason you fall down here, you're soft locked. There's no way out over here, because you can't push these. And he can't get out from over here because we don't have the hot dog yet. So maybe you can get out around here. Let's see. There you go. Maybe you can actually get out here. Maybe that's not a soft lock. Okay. You're actually good if that happens. So if that does happen, that's what you can do. You can do a bomb jump from here. Right up there. Okay, so that's not a soft lock. You're still good. But anyways, the way that you want to do it is you want to go over here. And we're going to be heading out through this exit right here. That's how you properly do that. But if for whatever reason you end up down there, then don't worry about it too much. You can still get out. Okay, so from here, you're going to head out this way. Down this way. You want to be doing short hops along the sand. And we're going to be exiting down this little staircase here. So now we're kind of back on the intended path of where the game wants us to be. We go into this, and this is the little cave where we get the sand cape. So this is all as intended for this part. Just do your little short hops around here, over to the chest. Open our menu, get our sand cape out. Which again, remember that the menus wrap around, so if it's faster to press up at the top of the screen, then do that. And we leave this part. So for this, there's a few different ways to do this. The quickest way is to do this. You jump from there to there, there to there, here along here, and then here to this center part here. And you go down and trigger the tornado thing here. If for whatever reason you screw up these jumps, like here you go, oh no, I didn't make the jump, oh no! You can actually go down this way, down over here, around this way, and up over here. So it loses you a bit of time, but that's the alternate way to get there if for whatever reason you fall off of the jump there. Okay, so now for this part. Here you want to hit circle immediately to go underneath the sand. Go through here and exit the screen north. For this part, you want to grab the first one. From here, jump up here. And then this is the tricky part. So from here, you just want to do a regular throw for that. Jump across there. And then for this screen, it's important that you exit the screen from down here. Because this puts you automatically up on this cliff. If you exit the screen like this way, it puts you down here. And then you'd need to do this jumping puzzle. If that happens, then the way that you do this is you go like that and like that. And that gets you across. But if you do it this way, you're already up on that ledge. And then from here, you jump across the right side, up onto there, and into the teleporter. Okay. So now we're inside the ancient shrine. Congrats, you made it. And now we're up over here. Okay, so this is the US version. These things take, I believe, 3 hits to die. Oh no, it's 2 hits, okay. That works out. I thought there's a health difference, but there isn't. Okay, so in both versions, you just want to hit those with your flail. And then move on this way. Hug the bottom of the screen here. Hit these. And now this room can be a pain. So this is one of the more dangerous rooms in the dungeon. Start off by doing this. Get that guy to notice you like that, and then grab the other one. So these guys are very predictable for a lot of their movements. But sometimes they can be jerks. What's important for when you're throwing these from up there down here is that you steer clear of the stairs. So here's what happens if you throw this on the stairs. It just explodes. So if that happens, you need to go down here and reload the room and try again. I believe you can also get these stuck underneath stuff, like up there, but yeah, essentially you want to keep those away from there and put them on the proper pads to do this room as it's supposed to be. So you just dump those over there, get on here. If your health is a little low here, don't worry about it, because once you talk to the statue, you're going to get your health back. Each time you talk to a statue in this dungeon, your health goes back to full, so don't fret too much if your health gets low during that run. Don't use like your herb or anything unless you're in really immediate danger of dying. Alright, so you hop up here. If for whatever reason you don't have two magic at this point, back here at the save point, right here, you can go get your magic back, because it's important that you have two, and that you have... Oh god. Okay, I hit the load save button. Alright, let's do this again. Luckily that isn't a huge waste. Hey, remember this room? Let's do it again. Yeah, if you don't have your magic back, and you don't have the MP potion, which you should have both at this point, then you should refill your magic at the same point. Alright, so this room. So this, grab this, throw it from there, grab that, throw it from there. Grab this, throw it from there. Grab this, throw it from there. Easy peasy. This room, you want to dash left, up, right, and into this door. And then this room, I start by just throwing the star there. I grab this and then get the moon. Go down here, throw that over. Throw that there. Grab this. Throw that over. And then go on up here. Oh, or jump up here. Either way. So it's kind of up to you how you want to do that room fast. That's how I do it. Okay, so there is a strat for the next part. In this, the next room, we need to get to the bottom, bottom door before, before the door closes. So, if you step on any of these things, you hear that mmm sound, and then the door is closed. So you're intended to take this all the way around the room here, and put it here and jump over. But, if you get over here, right to this until you stop moving, pick it up, jump and throw it, and then jump from here and then onto here. And that will get you over without having to go around the entire room. Okay, this part can be dangerous because these guys patrol and they can be in the middle of the walkway and just in your way, and there's nothing you can do about it. So if they are in a bad spot, you can hit them to move them back, but sometimes that doesn't get them out of the way. Here you want to go under the sands ASAP. Get out of the sand right here, so that the worm isn't in the way. For this, you want to go under the sand ASAP. Okay. Alright, so what I do is I hit two of them to get them out of the way, and then throw a rock over there. This room is also super random, so if things don't quite work out, then that's sometimes not your fault. Okay, do that to get that. Here you want to hit that one, hit that one, hit that one, that one. You want to get all these worms before they escape under the sand. So just practice doing that a few times. This, you want to stand here, throw that there. Hit the switch, grab this, stand right at the border, and then just go across like that. Okay, for this room, just leave. Doesn't matter if your health is low, because we're going to get it back right here. Talk to the statue. We get our health back. And then we move on. Watch out for this guy. Yeah, see, he was in a really bad spot there. There was nothing we could really do about that one. Alright, on to this one. Okay. Alright, exit the left side of this one, hold left. Hug this side, hug the bottom of the wall while jumping to get through that quickly. Dash down for this, and then up into the store. Watch out for the two guys here at the top of the stairs. Okay, for this, dodge this guy. Go down here, sometimes there's a guy there at the bottom of the ladder. This guy patrols, there's only one of them down here. And then on into this room, this is the pillar pushing room. Okay, so for this one, we need to put a pillar here, and then hit this while it's over on the left side. But first things first, go up here. If your health is a little low, you can break these pots, and they generally almost always have health. So we're going to be pushing this pillar to the left. You want to be just high enough here so that we can still push this to the left. And we want to push this pillar until it's in the kind of center left of this plant here. So right about there. So the important bit here is that we have enough room to fit around the left side of this pillar. And that we're far enough to the left that this ball won't hit us. So this is just something that requires practice, but you'll get it. You kind of just have to eyeball it. So we push this down until it's right about there, and then you push it to the right to hit that switch, run across there, and then up and out. Okay, so next is the B room. So the B room is one of the reasons why we saved our magic. So we equip the earth book here before this room if you haven't already, and then go inside the room. Go in here, in the center, and then cast the earth book magic. And then that should get all of the bees. There we go, that got all of them. Sometimes it doesn't get all of them. And then there are multiple strats to do this. The old strat is to do this. And then right here, you just throw that up onto there. The alternative strat to do this is to go up here, get along this, hit down, jump, and throw. Or if you do it properly. But this is a brand new strat as of today's recording. There we go. And that bounces it up off of the wall onto the switch, which is pretty good. So let me see if I can get that one more time here. Again, just something to practice. You can't be too close to the wall. Yeah, there you go. That's how you do that. Okay, this next room here. The direction, or the location that the barrels drop here, depends on which direction you're facing. So if you're facing to the right, they drop that way. If you're facing to the left, they drop over there. So, for this, you want to be facing this way. Drop that one there. Drop that one there. And then we can jump out. Okay, this next room's on a timer. So that one there. That one there. That one there. And that one there. And then grab the chest. Okay. So again, don't worry about your health here, even though there's bees. Just leave the room. Because we're going to get our health back right here. Trigger that. Talk to the statue. And that's all the statues for this part of the dungeon. So now we're going to make our way back to the first room of the dungeon. Oh god. So if you do lose health from here until the we get back to the start of the dungeon, we're going to get it back. Because it's important that you have health for the next phase of the dungeon. So here we're going to drop down and then up into the door here. Alright, so if you're not at full health or not confident with the next part here, you go into the save point, get your health back, also get your magic back, because sure, why not? While we're here. And then next thing is to talk to Spooky Skeleton right here. Alright. There's a few ways to do this room here. The fast way to do this room is to damage boost. Like that. The other way to do it, the much safer way that keeps your health, is to equip your bomb and ride the platform. Looks like I missed one of the things there. So another thing to note here is that there is damage boosting here. I'm going to load this up and turn on infinite health so that we can see what damage boosting looks like here. So as I jump into these spikes, before I land, I'm going to turn to face down. That pushes me back. So you can see when I'm on the steps, it's pushing me backwards. So if I wanted to go right, I would face left. So, in effect here, you're going to jump down and then go like that. And then this way, we'll knock you back that way. So that's how you do the damage boosting in Alundra. There's a few spots where we do stuff like that to be pointed in the direction we want to end up going. Alright, so let's get our health the way it should be. Oh. Alright, unfreeze address. Okay. Now we're gonna be properly damaged again. Okay. So if you're doing the damage boost strat, that's generally what that's gonna be. For this room, you wanna stand right here, and then cast your Earth Magic. This should get all the worms. If not, then just kill the last remaining one. If you use a pot, it'll one-shot it, so if you have time, go and grab a pot to hit the worm. Okay, so the next room is the first rotating panel puzzle. So in this room, I'm also going to... let's freeze that. Here, I'm gonna kill these guys so that they're out of our way. Okay. So these panels here rotate in the same rotation. So it's sun, star, moon, water drop. And that just continues over and over again. Or earth, I guess, is what that is. The order in which the panels go is the same every single time. So once you learn the order, it's no big deal. Okay. So you're generally going to want to do this room without killing the dudes in it. And the way that I... time throwing those is that... So if I want to put this on the water one, I time it so that I know that water is always going to be after moon. So I time my throw so that when moon is actually the thing it's on here, that's when I throw it. Because the travel time that takes to go from here to there is the time it takes for the panel to change. So wait for it to be moon and then throw it. Wait for this to be star and then throw it. Wait for this to be sun and then throw it. Oh god. And then wait for this to be water droplet and then throw it. And that's the way I do those. Okay, this room. This room can be horrible. So these guys have ended many of an Alundra run before. These guys take a ton of hits to kill. If you haven't fought them yet. They are tanks. You can kill them with your flail with a ton of hits. The other way to kill them is with, I believe it's a single bomb will kill them. But actually getting them to cooperate and be caught with a bomb can be horrible. So when you kill that last guy, you want to be standing right underneath this, because this is the first piece we're going to get. So to solve this, you do water, earth. It's right-left is the solution to this, if you just want to think of it that way. Just like that. Don't worry about being too precise with this. The game accepts close enough. So, right-left is the solution there. And then down here is the next set of rotating puzzle stuff. Spiriax has a really cool strat to do this quickly. I do not, so I just start from the north one. You can see which one it is because it's SWEN. And same deal here, these are always going to be in the same order. You always want to do the south one last if you're doing my strats. Because that's the closest to the exit. So you do that one, go left, make sure to hop across this, into here. Alright, and then right up here is the boss. So, for this, there's, this is the reason why we had the magic potion. Okay. So for this, we want to have the Earth Book out. And we want to use the Earth Book right there when he's hit the ground. And we want this to hit as many times as we can. So before the fight, chances are you probably had zero MP. So you would have wanted to... I've used this. And then use this again right here. And that will work. So two of those will kill the boss. And that's way faster than actually fighting him as intended. We could technically do the infinite bomb trick, but it doesn't save time compared to just going and getting the magic upgrade, so you're going to want to get the magic upgrade. Alright, so next we get up on here. In the next room, you want to move as quickly as possible. So you generally want to exit from the left side of this. Start tapping X and then down and left. Go up on here, and then for this, you're going to want to hit this, turn and face the right to get that. Put that one there, and then same deal, hit that, turn and face right here to get that. Put that one there, and then just move like this between these two until it hits both, and then go through this door. This next part's the maze part. So this is a big old maze that has holes in the floors. If you happen to fall in a hole in the floor like this, it puts you in the basement of this part. If you end up here, don't worry about it too much. It happens to everybody. If you need health, just get some from there. And you go up the stairs and then start the maze again. So it just puts you right here. Okay. So to make the way through the maze here, generally you don't ever want to sprint or dash through this. Because it's, unless you're in a TAS, it won't matter. But hit these, go through here. If you were going to dash, that would be one of the few places to do it. Up through here. There is enough leeway on a lot of these that you could stop and, like, measure your jumps for a lot of these. Especially the one where you have to do two short hops right next to each other. And, like, this right here. If you need to, you can hesitate for a second before jumping. Like that one in particular. This one I usually stop and set myself up before I jump. As it does give you a little bit of time. Like right there, we had plenty of time to make it through there, even though I stopped on both occasions. Okay, so in this next screen, this is one of the more random parts of the dungeon. So after we talk to this guy, you can see we have one cast of magic left. And after this, a bunch of zombies spawn down here. So what we're going to do is we're going to move down to this spot right about here and then cast the Earthbook spell. So it's pretty much random what path the enemies take when they start moving. And then what's also random is the path that the meteors take when they're landing on the screen. So that actually got almost all of them. And then for the ones that are still alive, you can just get them like that. So, that actually went really well. Okay, and that's where I split for Ancient Shrine 2. So thus ends part 2 of the tutorial. This ended up being a bit over an hour, which is... sure, that's about how long this takes. Okay, so after the fight, it just leaves you here. And this is where we will leave off on the tutorial. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you for part 3.